Hey all, welcome to homeschool and welcome back to class 11 chemistry series. In my previous video, I have told you how to solve the numericals on Bohr's model of an atom. And we have discussed everything about Bohr's model in a detailed way. Video links are provided in the description. You can just go and watch it out. And coming to today's topic, it is hydrogen spectrum. Okay, we are specially studying line emission spectrum of hydrogen. It is line emission spectrum of hydrogen atom. So this is really very, very important concept for competitive examinations. Not only for competitive exams, it's important for PUC board, it's important for CBSE board or whatever may be the board that you belong to. Clear? Fine. See, Bohr told us when actually the radiations can be emitted from the atom, right? I'll just revise one postulate from the Bohr. He says, whenever atom absorbs energy, say if this is your atom which is having a nucleus at the center, it has many shells around it. Suppose if electron is there in first shell, when you provide radiation from outside, when you provide some electricity or when you provide some kind of light, what will happen? This electron absorbs that light and it will go to higher energy level. It may go to second level or it may go to third level. But there it will not stay for a longer time. It has to come back to its original position. While coming back to its original position, what would happen? Whatever the energy it has absorbed now for going up, the same amount of energy will get released in the form of radiation or light. Okay, so this radiation, okay, can be recorded as a spectra where you will get thin lines on a dark background. This is what we called emission spectrum. Isn't it? So this was the thing explained by Bohr. So why do you get atomic spectra like this? It's because when the electron comes back to its original position, okay, say these things we will call them as transitions. So what do you mean by transition? Electron going from its original shell to higher level, or electron coming back from higher shell to original shell. So this jumping of electrons is there, no? That is called with the word transition in chemistry. So whenever you find the word transition, it means what? Jumping of electron from one energy level to another energy level. Okay, so remember the meaning of the word transition here. Okay, so okay, all that we understood, why actually we get spectra, everything was explained by Bohr. And now the same thing we will try to apply for getting line emission spectrum for hydrogen. Okay, so what they have done is they took hydrogen gas in a glass tube. So they took hydrogen gas, in particular glass tube, and they supplied electricity. They supplied electricity. Okay, fine. So initially what can happen here is your H2 molecules are there now. They will get separated into hydrogen atoms. Okay, many H2 molecules would be there. All of them would break and you will get individual hydrogen atoms. And now you may have crores and crores of hydrogen atoms. So each hydrogen atom has a nucleus, and you know around that there are many, 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 many shells. Isn't it? Okay, so now from outside you are supplying this electricity. So where is your electron located in hydrogen? It is located in first orbit. Okay, so in every hydrogen atom, your electron is located in first orbit. Okay, so the moment you supply this electricity, this electron absorbs energy in the form of electricity and it may jump to any energy level. Okay, say electron can jump to first energy level, or the electron can jump to second energy level, or in some of the atoms the electron can jump to third energy level, it can jump to fourth energy level, like that it can jump to infinity energy level. Okay, so you will have infinity energy levels. Either electron can jump to first, second, third, like that it can jump to infinity levels. Okay, but there will it stay for a longer time? No, it has to come back to its original position, right? Say, while coming back to its original position, what would happen? The radiations gets emitted outside. Okay, so these radiations, when you record as a spectra, you will find series of lines. Okay, so you will actually find many series of lines, which we will call it as hydrogen line spectrum. Okay, so this is how hydrogen line spectrum looks like. Okay, you will have series of lines. This is one set of lines. This is another set of lines. This is third set of lines. This is fourth set of line. Okay, like that series of lines are formed. Okay, why these lines are formed? It's because when electron is coming back to its original position, this is emitting radiation. But different kinds of radiations will get emitted. That's the reason different series of lines you will get. So why it will emit different types of radiations? That one I will try to make you understand now. Okay, so listen, very very important. Suppose guys, if this is a nucleus of hydrogen atom, this is N is equal to 1, first shell, this is second shell, this is third shell, this is our fourth shell, fifth shell, like that there are so many shells, and finally you will have one infinity shell. Okay, I'm not drawing complete shell here, just half a shell I'm drawing, half a part. Right, okay. So in our hydrogen, our electron is there in a first energy level. The moment you supply electricity, electron may go to second shell, or in some atoms, there are crores of atoms in a particular amount of gas. In some hydrogen atoms, electron will jump to second energy level on absorbing radiation. That is, you are providing it in the form of electricity, right? On absorbing that, electron may jump to second energy level, or electron may jump to third energy level in some atoms. In some of the atoms, the same electron may jump to fourth energy level, or in some of the atoms, this electron will jump to fifth energy level. Likewise, it can also jump to infinity level. Okay, so depending on the atoms, that how much energy it is absorbing, you know, electron jumps to different levels in different hydrogen atoms which is present in a particular gas. Okay, so now, okay, by absorbing radiation in different atoms, electron has jumped to different energy levels. Fine, but there it cannot stay for a longer time. It has to come back to its original position. Right? Say, whichever the atom, the electron jumped to a second level, from there if it is directly coming to first energy level. In whichever the atoms, the electron jumped to third energy level, from there if it is directly coming to the first energy level. In whichever the atoms, the electron jumped to the fourth level, from there if it is directly coming back to the first, then like this. Whichever the atoms, the electron jumped to infinity level, from there if it is directly coming to the first energy level. You know, say when these transitions occur, say when electron jumping from second to first, what happens? Energy is emitted. So that emitted radiation, when you record a spectra, you get a line. See, in some of the hydrogen atom, this transition was happening, energy is emitted. Now that gives one line. And this transition, energy is emitted. Now that gives another line. Like that, you get first series of lines. So when did you get these lines will stay together as one group? So why they stay together as one group is because all these radiations belong to same region of electromagnetic spectrum. That is UV region. Okay, clear? So whatever the radiation emitted now by these transitions in different atoms of hydrogen, you know, all those radiations were more or less had, you know, same frequency, wavelength and energy, which exactly matches to UV radiations, wavelength, frequency and energy. Right? Okay, so that's how you got the first series of lines, which we will call it as Lyman series. Okay, so when you get Lyman series, electron might have jumped to whichever energy level by absorbing radiation. But when they are coming back directly, if they are going to first energy level, okay, then energy emitted, no, that emitted radiation's energy exactly matches with UV region's radiation's energy. So that's why those series of lines we will call it as Lyman series. Okay, it's not that electron must directly go to the first shell. Sometimes what happens is electron will go to second energy level first. Okay, say if the electron is there in third energy level, instead of going to first, if it is going to second, again from second it will go to first, no doubt. Again from second it will go to first. Okay, but initially what's happening? The electron, if in some atom, if it is there in a third energy level, without directly going to the first, if it is going to the second, okay, or from any energy level, if it is going to the second energy level instead of first, okay, then these transitions will give another series of lines, which we will call it as Balmer series. Okay, I'll take a different color. So this is Balmer series. Okay, and when we calculated frequency, wavelength and energy of these radiations, it was exactly similar to frequency, energy and wavelength of visible region. Visible region. Okay, you're getting my point, right? It's not that it should directly go to the first. Finally, from here it will go to first. No need to worry. Okay, clear? Again, from second to, if it is going to the first, what type of radiation is emitted? It's again UV radiation. You see, this transitions, when this transition was happening, the emitted radiation's energy, when you calculate, it becomes, you know, similar to UV region, right? So again, one more line you will get there. But if these transitions occur, right, from anywhere, if it is directly going to n is equal to 2 shell, second shell, then those radiations collectively will form as one group. You know, their energies, these radiations' energy is exactly similar to visible region. It comes, it falls in visible region. Okay? So that's how. And now, see, now here, without going directly to the first shell, if it is going to third shell, okay, so if it is from infinity, it may go to third shell, and from fifth shell it may go to third shell, or from fourth shell it may go to third shell, right? Say again, from third shell it will go back to its original shell. Okay, so that's different. But initially, from wherever may be the shell, if the electron is jumping first to the third shell, okay, then this transition involves the emission of some radiation. So those radiations will form as one group collectively. Okay, so they are called with the name Passion series. Okay, Passion series. Okay, and now let us list out this. See here, for Lyman series, N1 is what value, N2 is what value. So what do you mean by N1 and N2? So N1 in the sense, the lower energy level to where electron is jumping. Okay, so N1 is what? Lower lower energy level to where electron is jumping. N2 is what? Higher energy level from the shell electron is jumping. Okay, say lower energy level means to which shell initially the electron is jumping, and higher energy level means from where the electron is jumping. Say for Lyman series, ultimately to which shell the electron is coming back? It is to n is equal to 1. So n1 value for Lyman series is always 1. Okay, what can be N2 value? From where electron is jumping? Electron is jumping from second shell. It can be a jump from third shell. It can be a jump from fourth shell, right? So N2 values can be 2, it can be 3, it can be 4, like that. It can be till infinity. It can be till infinity, right? Okay, so let me write it here. 1, 2, like that, infinity. Okay, fine. So now like that only, can you tell me what is N1 value for Balmer series and N2 value for Balmer series? Okay, so N1 is what? Lower energy level. It is to the energy level electron is jumping from higher shells onwards. Say for Balmer series, say this is our Lyman series. This is our Lyman series, right? Balmer series means this one. Okay, so for Balmer series, N1 is equal to 2. See, electron from higher shells, electron is jumping to second shell. N2 will start from 3, 4 till infinity. It may go up to infinity, right? So likewise, you know what? This transition, if the electrons are going to third energy level instead of directly going to the first, then these transitions will emit radiations. Now those radiations will actually belong to IR region of electromagnetic spectrum. Okay, so for passion series, can you tell me what is N1 value? N1 value, lower energy level to where it is jumping, third. Okay, what is N2 value? 4, 5 till infinity. Okay, so likewise you have another series of lines. Okay, so which we will call it as bracket series. It is called as bracket series. These radiations also belong to IR, and here N1 value is equal to 4. That means from higher shells the electron will go to fourth shell, like this. Okay, if the transition from wherever it is, if the electron is jumping to fourth one, then this is called as bracket. This is passion. Okay, so here N1 is 4, N2 will start from 5, 6 till infinity. And you have one more series. Okay, so that is fund series. P-F-U-N-D. P is silent here. Okay, so for fund series also belong to IR region only. And here N1 value is 5. N2 value will start from 6, 7, 8, goes up to infinity. Okay, so like this, you will have different series of lines in line emission spectrum of hydrogen. So, understood, right? Why we got different series of lines? It's because electron always directly will not go to the first shell. It may initially go with second and then from second to first, or it may go to third shell and then from third shell it will go to first. So, depending on the different transitions, you know, we had got different lines, you know, on the hydrogen spectrum. Right, so these radiations, that see the lines corresponding to these radiations, these transitions, right? So they belong to, those radiations actually belong to UV region, and they are called as Lyman series. Like that, we have different types of series. Okay, so usually in a textbook there is a way of mentioning these transitions. Okay, so let us draw that particular diagram now. See guys, this is N is equal to 1, that is first shell, and this is your second shell. This is your N is equal to third shell, N is equal to fourth shell, N is equal to fifth shell, N is equal to sixth shell, like that. Okay, N is equal to infinity shell. Okay, you see the energy gap. You see, I have put a large gap between first shell and second shell. Then gap suddenly decreased as you go up. Okay, it is actually the energy gap. Do you remember? We know the formula to calculate energy of a particular energy level or energy of electron present in energy level. Say for the first energy level, what was the energy we got? I told you to remember values for hydrogen spectrum, right? Or, you know, the hydrogen atom. So here you will get the energy minus 13.6 electron volt. So here you will have 3.4 electron volt. So here you have 0.8 minus 0.8 electron volt, and here minus 0.5 electron volt. You see, what is the difference between 13.6 and 3.4? It is 10. But what is the difference between 3.4 and 0.8? It's lesser than this, right? And the difference between these two is much lesser than this. That's why the diagram looks like this. Okay, so you between first and second, huge difference, and then the difference decreases, right? Okay, so if the electron is coming back to first energy level from wherever it may be, from whichever energy shell, if it is directly coming back to first energy level, then we will call it as Lyman series, right? Fine. And if the electron is coming to second energy level from higher shells, then we will call it as Balmer series. Okay, if it is coming to this energy level, n is equal to 3 shell, then we will call it as Passion series. Like that you can draw it for this one, bracket series. How do you draw? If the electron comes to n is equal to 4th shell, then we will call it as bracket series. Like that you can draw it for fund series also. For fund series, you will draw like this. This is fund series. Okay, so this is how you will show the transitions. Okay, fine. This is really very important. And now, what I'm going to tell you is, you need to know all these for competitive exams. Okay, and you know what? This line, if n is equal to 2, n is equal to 2 line is called as limiting line. So they'll ask you, which is a limiting line for Lyman series? Say this line, the longest transition. Okay, longest transition. I say this is longest transition because high energy gap is there, right? So first point, point number one, longest transition. Transition is called limiting line. Limiting line. Okay, so here your n2 value is always equal to infinity. Okay, n1 varies. For Lyman, n1 is 1. For Balmer, n1 is what? 2. For bracket, n1 is 4. For fund, n1 is 5. N1 value may vary. But if n2 value is always infinity, you know, that is the longest transition. When I say which is the longest transition in Lyman series, then you would say this. So this is your limiting line. And which is the limiting line in Balmer series? Longest transition, this one, right? So this is your limiting line in Balmer series. Which is the limiting line in Passion series? This one, longest line. This is the limiting line in Passion series. So you must able to identify which is a limiting line. Okay, fine. And now there is a formula called Rydberg formula. Okay, so this is very, very important. What is the use of Rydberg formula? Rydberg formula helps to calculate lambda, okay, or wave number. Okay, wave number symbol is this. Lambda means what? Wavelength, right? This is, you can either calculate wavelength or wave number of spectral lines. Okay, what do you mean by this? See, all these are spectral. This is one spectral line. Spectral line means what? This corresponds to the radiation that is emitted when electron was jumping from second shell to first shell, right? So that is what the spectral line means. This corresponds to that radiation that is emitted when electron is jumping from this level to this level. So that is one spectral line. So if you want to find out which radiation it is, you can either find that by knowing lambda, wavelength or energy, right? So now Rydberg is the person who has given a formula to calculate lambda of these radiations or wave number of this radiation. Okay, say the formula is 1 by lambda is equal to R into Z square 1 by N1 square by N2 square. Okay, so this is really a very, very important formula. Whereas R is equal to Rydberg constant, its value is 109677 centimeter inverse or 1.0 into 10 power 7 meter inverse. Okay, so actually this is the value of Rydberg constant. R is what? Rydberg constant. And what do you mean by Z? Z is equal to atomic number. It is nothing but atomic number. Okay, what is the atomic number for hydrogen? If you have to calculate for frequency or lambda of any spectral line of hydrogen, then this formula you can use. What is the Z value you will substitute? Z value is equal to 1 for hydrogen atom. Okay, so now for any single electron species, spectral lines, the radiation's wavelength, you need to find out, then we can use this formula. Okay, so we know what is N1 and N2, right? For Lyman series, N1 is always 1 and N2 is, it can start from 2, 3, 4 onwards. And for Balmer series, N1 is always 2 and N2 can be higher value. And for Passion series, N1 is always 3 and N2 can be higher numbers. Right, like that, if you know the transition, right, if you know like which electron is jumping from which energy level to which energy level, and that corresponding spectral lines lambda you want to find out, then you can always use this formula. Okay, so once you know the lambda, you can find out frequency, right? Or you can find out energy. It's because you have a formula, no? E is equal to h nu is there. Or the same formula, we can write it as E is equal to hc by lambda. So if you can find the lambda, if they ask frequency, you can calculate. If they ask energy, you can calculate. Right? So any one thing if you find, rest all things, frequency or energy, can be automatically calculated. Okay, so now we will go for some questions that they can ask for competitive examinations. See guys, suppose if the question is calculate lambda or wavelength of limiting line of Lyman series. Okay, so then how do you do? First, what is the formula you will use? Calculate the wavelength. So we have a relation, 1 by lambda is equal to R into Z square 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. Right, fine. And now you see here, lambda we have to calculate. Okay, so what do we need? R is anyway constant. Z is what? Atomic number. So Z value for hydrogen is 1. They will mention for which atom it is. It is for hydrogen atom. Z value is 1. Right. So here for limiting line in the sense, what did I tell you? Biggest line, longest transition is called limiting line. Okay. So shortest transition means this one, shortest line in all the series. Longest transition means the biggest line, that is N2 is equal to infinity. And what is N1 for Lyman series? N1 for Lyman series is 1. Okay, so substitute in the formula. 1 by lambda is equal to, what is R value? I gave R value as 109677 centimeter inverse. But when you put this value, you know, calculation will become very long and it will take long time. Whereas for the competitive exam, you don't have much time for the question, right? You need to complete the question by 30 seconds. That would be much better, right? So, or 1 minute. So what I will do, R, let me take it as R only. I don't put this value. I'm making calculation much easier. Observe it. Okay, so it's the best trick that you can use for your competitive examinations. Fine. And now N1 value is what? 1 square, right? 1 square minus N2 value is what? N2 value is infinity, infinity square. So this whole thing will become what? This whole thing will become 0. 1 by infinity is 0. So 1 by R is 1 by lambda is equal to R. Just R you have. Lambda is equal to 1 by R. Isn't it? See, now 1 by R value will be approximately equal to 911 angstrom. Remember this. Instead of remembering this value for R, you can just remember this. You need to calculate 1 by lambda. Right? But lambda, if you want, it's 1 by R. So 1 by R's value is approximately this much angstrom. You will get your answer in angstrom. Okay, clear everyone? So now lambda is equal to, it is just 911 angstrom. Okay, or in you can also use 911.5 angstrom. So any value you can use. So just approximate answer, you will get it off. Okay, so now what is the lambda value for this line? This is what the limiting line now. So here lambda value, how much you got? It is 911 angstrom or 911.5 angstrom. Okay, say now, if they would have asked you first line of Lyman series, if they would have asked you, wavelength of first line of Lyman series, then how do you calculate? Just N1 and N2 values will vary, isn't it? So what is your N1 value here? So N1 value for Lyman series is always 1. And N2 value is what? They are asking first line. Which is the first line? This is your first line. Okay. So first line is, see, N2 is equal to 2. From second shell, electron is jumping to first shell. So minimum value always you take, as N1. Maximum value, first line means electron is jumping from second shell, that you need to understand. So here N2 is equal to 2. Okay, so just do the calculation. 1 by lambda is equal to, write it as R. Z value is anyway 1 here, 1 square. Okay, so 1 by N1 is 1 square minus, and here it is 4. So 1 by lambda is equal to R into 1 by 1. Right? 2 square, right? So here 2 square, yes, that is 4 only, right? So what do you get? R into, say, 4 as LCM, and here 4 minus 1, 3, right? So 1 by lambda is equal to this much you got. Now can I write lambda is equal to 4 by 3 into 1 by R. Yes or no? Lambda, I want inverse. Lambda is equal to, it was 3 by 4, 1 by lambda was 3 by 4. Now lambda is equal to inverse, that is 4 by 3, right? 4 by 3 into 1 by R. So what I can do here, 4 by 3 into what I told you, 1 by R value is approximately, take it as 911 angstrom. So 911 angstrom. See, here easily you can calculate 3 ones are 3, 303, right? So 303 into 4 if you do, 1214 angstrom, isn't it? See, if you have used R value as this, your calculation will become little more complicated, right? It takes lot of time. Whereas instead of that, you can remember 1 by R is equal to 911 angstrom. See, now what is the wavelength of this particular line? You got 1214 angstrom. You see the range, 1214 angstrom to 911 angstrom. If you remember the lambda range of electromagnetic spectrum, this range will fall under UV radiation. That's why I told you this series of line belong to UV. Okay, so like that, when I asked you to calculate the first line of Balmer, then what is n1 value? 2. n2 value? 3. Substitute, calculate this way. Okay, and then limiting line of Balmer, if I had asked you, then n1 value 2, n2 value infinity. Calculate and give the answer. So this is how the questions can be asked. Or they will ask you questions something like this. This is also the most important type of question, the third type of question I'm telling you. See, calculate energy of radiation emitted. Energy of radiation emitted when electron jumped from third energy level to second energy level. Okay, so you need to calculate energy. So what's the relationship between energy and lambda? E is equal to hc by lambda, isn't it? Okay, so here to calculate energy, this is constant. H value we know, it is 6.6 into 10 power minus 34. This is your H value. C value you know, it's velocity of light, that is 3 into 10 power 8 meter per second. Isn't it? So lambda you want. Isn't it? So how do you calculate lambda here? So calculate lambda, 1 by lambda, Rydberg, with Rydberg equation you can calculate lambda, isn't it? So 1 by lambda is equal to Rz square by 1 by n1 square minus n2 square, right? So here what is n1 and what is n2? You see, electron is jumping from third level to second level. Okay, so always n1 is what? Least number. That way you try to remember. If you are getting confused, say among the two numbers, least number you take it as n1. N1 is 2, n2 is equal to 3. This is how you can remember. Okay, so now just calculate lambda. 1 by lambda is equal to, I'll not put this value for r. Okay, I'll do it in much simple way. I use 1 by r instead. Okay, so r into 1 by 2 square minus 3 square, right? So 2 square is what? 2 square is 4 and 3 square is what? 3 square is 9, right? So now here 1 by lambda is equal to r into, so what do you get here? Here you will get LCM as 9 fours, let me take it as 36, right? So 36 in the numerator, what do you get? You will get 9 minus 4, right? So 9 minus 4 is what? Directly I will write 5 by 36, okay? So now lambda is equal to how much? Lambda is equal to 36 by 5 into 1 by r. So what is 1 by r? Lambda is equal to 36 by 5 into 911, isn't it? So when you do lambda value, lambda is equal to how much do you get here? So here 5 ones are right, it's 5 ones are 5 and then I can say it is 8, right? 4 carry over 182, yes. So 182 into 36, how much do you get? You will get around 6559 angstrom, right? So this is your lambda value. But this is not what they are asking here. They are asking you energy, right? So Lambda value you got. Substitute in this formula. So E is equal to, what is H value? 6.6 into 10 power minus 34 into C value is, what is C value? 3 into 10 power 8 divided by, what is lambda? Lambda 6559 angstrom. Angstrom means what? 10 power minus 10 meters. Okay. So you will get your energy. You will get your value for energy. Okay, in case if they had asked you to calculate frequency, instead of energy, if they had asked frequency, then what is the formula you will use? You have a relationship between frequency and lambda, isn't it? So what is that? C is equal to lambda nu you have. So nu is equal to C by lambda, right? So first with Rydberg equation, find lambda, then use this formula to calculate frequency.
like that. See the radiations, any transitions, lambda you can calculate. If you know lambda, you can calculate energy later, or you can also calculate frequency. Whichever they ask, that you can calculate. So you have to be very, very careful with N1 and N2 value. Okay, so you must identify which is N1 and which is N2. If the question is like this, always the lowest number is N1, highest number is N3. Okay, but when they ask calculate lambda of first line of Lyman series, limiting line of Lyman series, you have to be very, very careful. You must know the concept. Okay, see, I think I have covered all possible questions on hydrogen spectrum. And there is one more concept is remaining, that is calculation of spectral lines. Okay, so that calculation of spectral lines will be dealt in the next class. So in my next class, a bit of hydrogen spectrum is remaining, that's calculation of hydrogen spectrum. Along with that, I will start with de Broglie equation as well as Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. Okay, so both are very, very important. So I have given a complete knowledge on hydrogen spectrum. Use this. Actually, these types of problems have come in the previous NEET paper. So you have to be very, very careful. Thank you so much. Do subscribe our channel to learn the concepts in an easiest way and in a detailed way. See you all in the next video.